Anything you need, Commander?
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Killing Saren's, I'm sure Dr. Tassoni's hurting, though.
We'll talk another time, Commander.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I like talking with you, Liara, no matter what the subject.
Then let us talk about you. Are you okay?
I'm not sleeping well. The visions keep me up at night.
I wish there was something I could do to help you. You need to be at your best, Commander. The crew relies on you for leadership. It can be a heavy burden.
I can handle the responsibility of command. But if I don't stop Saren, the entire galaxy gets wiped out.
I'm sorry, Commander. The last thing you need is someone constantly reminding you of how grim things are. Is there anything else you would rather talk about?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but if there's anything else I can do to help, anything. Just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
I understand your concern, but we'll find him. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do.
Yes, sir. I'll be ready. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
I get the feeling this isn't a question. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
If Saren won't listen to reason, if he forces my hand, I'll kill him in a heartbeat. But only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him. And what about the Geth? They might try to free him.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone. But what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Maybe, maybe not. But it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, sir.
There's a reason for everything that happened, Shepard, even if you don't understand it at the time. What happened on Akuz, it's not easy to lose your unit, I know. But it gave you the drive you needed on this mission. And that got you here, commanding the finest tin can in the Alliance fleet. This is exactly where the galaxy needs you to be. No pressure.
So when can I expect you to stop jerking me around?
Sorry. I'll be serious. I need time to think. We've been focused on the mission. When we're done, it'll be different, I swear. I hope you can wait.
I'll just requisition myself some cold showers.
That's the spirit, Skipper. Keep a stiff upper... something. I'll warn you, though. I'm a Hellcat off the battlefield, too. Sleep tight, Shepard.
Never a dull moment with you, Shepard.
You ever go on any missions like ours before?
Saving the galaxy from certain destruction? No. But I've had my share of adventures.
Do you remember any that stick out?
A few. I remember one time I was hired by a Volus diplomat. What an ass.
I guess even politicians have need of mercs from time to time, huh?
Time to time. If it wasn't for politicians, I'd be out of work. They're always looking for ways to get ahead. This one was no different. He wanted me to erase his past. Get rid of an old friend who knew too much. Huh. His old friend turned out to be an Asari commando.
I can see why that might give you pause.
What? No. Alina and I were old friends. Sort of. We met when we were both contracted to kill the same Turian. Neither of us wanted the other one to get him first. We spent more time fighting each other than tracking that Turian.
An Asari commando mercenary? That's unusual, isn't it?
I wouldn't say it's unusual. Mercs come in all shapes. Anyway, when I told Alina about the diplomat's contract, she and I had a good laugh about it.
So what did you do?
Well, I wasn't going to lose the contract, but I respected Alina. In the end, I let her pick the location where we'd fight. She chose some old Solarian space station overrun with mercs and smugglers. That way we didn't have to worry about hurting any innocent bystanders. She always was a bit of a softy.
What happened on the station?
What didn't happen? For 2 days, I chased her through that station, used my entire store of ammunition, had to kill a bunch of mercs and use their crap weapons. By the third day, the station was barely holding together. The mercs were dead or gone, life support was failing, but I had her. She'd locked herself in the med labs. She was trying to patch herself up. Damn tough, that one. Then just when I thought I had her, the station's core went critical. Barely made it back to my ship in time.
I assume the Asari commando didn't make it?
I watched the station from a distance. I never saw her leave. And when that place blew, there was nothing left larger than a Turian's right nut. So I headed back to the diplomat to give him the good news and collect my pay. But before I got halfway there, Alina sent me a message. Better luck next time. Now, I'm not superstitious. But if someone can survive that, well, they deserve to live. At least for a bit longer.
What about the diplomat? He wanted her dead.
I told him the truth. Alina was still alive and she was really pissed. I told him if he wanted to live, he'd need me around to protect him.
And he believed you.
He kept me on as his personal guard until he died. Natural causes. Easiest job I've ever had. A little boring, but credits are credits.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Hey, Shepard. You need something?
I should go.
See you later.
Thank you. Thank you.
moving out. Perimeter clear.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
Admiral Kahoku, a respected member of the Alliance military, has passed away. The veteran soldier who won the love of his troops during conflict with the Batarians died of natural causes. Kahoku is survived by his wife and three children, who are planning a small private memorial service.
I'm on a break. Talk to someone else if you need anything. I've got a lot on my mind.
I found your brother's body. His ship was attacked by privateers.
Willem's dead? I guess I should have expected this. When his ship dropped out of contact, I just knew. But I kept hoping he might still be alive.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Thank you for finding him. It's better to know one way or the other. That's what they say. Right? Please excuse me. I need to go make arrangements for his funeral.
Reporter Kalisa Al-Jilani recently attempted to land an interview with Commander Shepard, the first human Spectre. Commander Shepard answered difficult questions, demonstrating that under that military uniform is a keen diplomatic mind. We'll have exclusive footage later today.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Thank you.
This is the place. My armor's here somewhere. I can't believe my ancestors ever wore this piece of crap, but at least I've got it back.
I'm glad we could help you get it back.
I might just be starting to like you, Shepard.
Thank you.
Shepard?
You must have family other than your father. Don't you miss them?
No. Now that I have my family's armor again, there's nothing left for me.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.